Today, if I simply ask you what is my order status, you would be like, have you gone mad? What is the context, right? So, which means that whenever as a human we are talking, context becomes important. This is the same for any LLM and even for autopilot for everyone, right? So, today in this video, we would be exploring about context grounding in autopilot for everyone. Hi everyone, welcome back to the next video in the UiPath Autopilot for Everyone series, where we are trying to explore autopilot in a step-by-step manner. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am a 4 times UiPath MVP, Certified Solution Architect and a LinkedIn Top Vice. I have shared my LinkedIn details on the page. Feel free to send me a connection request and happy to be part of your network. Also, you can scan the QR which you see on the screen and join our WhatsApp community, where you get a direct notification whenever there is a video uploaded on the channel. And also, whenever you have some doubt, you can ask the question in the WhatsApp group and people try to help you there as well. Okay, so today in this video we are going to discuss about context grounding in autopilot for everyone. But before that, in case you are absolute beginner to autopilot for everyone and you have no idea where to get started, don't worry, we got you by this complete playlist where you would find everything in details, right from agentic, getting started, prompts, autopilot, ready to use tools. All of that is available for free. Just follow the playlist and you would be able to set it up on yourself, right? And lastly, before directly jumping to the video, in case you are coming to the channel for the first time, haven't already subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel to get the next videos in the same playlist. Having said that, let's get started. Okay, so first thing first, let's start by defining what exactly is context grounding, right? So in simple words, if I go by the definition, context grounding ensures AI understand and respond you based on the relevant information, right? So for example, if today I go to you and I say that what happened to the exam? That's it, right? I just give you a statement saying that what happened to the exam, right? Now, you are not sure whether you are talking my exam, your exam, but let's say we both are already in a communication where you were supposed to give, let's say, a solution architect exam or an advanced developer exam. Then if I ask you that what happened to the exam, so you already have a context that yes, we have been in communication, we have been in talk for this certification and Mukesh is asking me about that certification. So then you will answer me that yes, I have passed with flying colors, right? So that means the context becomes important and the same thing is important for an AI as well. Why it matters? Because it helps AI to give you the meaningful responses. It reduces the irrelevant and the incorrect responses and it helps user experience in automations and decision making, right? Simply the same way as a human we use context grounding, it is the same way. AI also need to understand the context of the information before you ask a question, right? For example, the same thing, right? If I ask you that what is my order status, you will get a generic response from an LLM. But with context grounding, you will get a response like your order 12345 is out for delivery. In simple words, context grounding means whenever you ask a question to the LLM, before that only the LLM have a background that what you are relating to, right? So that's simply context grounding, right? I am not going into detail of context grounding because we have already discussed context grounding in detail in this video, right? So you would find this complete video in the description where I have explained context grounding in a step-by-step manner, very basic. Please do refer to this video to make your agentic concept specifically around context grounding to be clear, and that will give you this complete understanding, right? Today, I am going to make you understand context grounding in autopilot for everyone, and at the end, I promise you that you guys would have enabled context grounding in autopilot and you would have also understood the concept in detail, right? And with that, let's go back to autopilot and see context grounding in action. Okay. Okay, so I am back to my autopilot for everyone, where we have set up this complete thing. We have seen how does the file upload work and everything, right? So today, to start with the context grounding, right? If I just go here, okay, and if I just ask it a simple question, right, that what activity Mukesh did in Las Vegas, right? So there is a popular saying, right, that what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, right? So if I just go to autopilot today and I ask it what activity Mukesh did in Las Vegas, it would search, look for that information, and then it says sorry, because it does not understand what actually Mukesh did, because I did not provide it the context. Okay. Even better, if today, if I just go to autopilot and I ask, who is Mukesh Kala? Or maybe let's just ask this, right? Who is Mukesh Kala? Okay. So, some information about me is already available on internet, and some information I have already given here. Right, Mukesh 2608 manager IT role to autopilot. So autopilot only have this information about me, so it is able to give me only that information, right? This is working with a limited context, which was this, and no context, which is here. So what happens if I run the same prompts, but this time I provide some context, right? So it is different from actually directly uploading a file and doing that, because that was just for the session related. You refresh the session, that part is gone. You cannot carry it forward. You cannot, it has some limitation on 5 pages and all those things, right? Context grounding is something else, where we would provide some context, upload it, and then we'll provide it to the complete instance of autopilot, right? So this is our problem statement. Let's see how do we address that. Okay. So first thing first, we'll go back to the automation cloud, which is cloud.uipart.com, right? This is the same tenant, guys, where we have been working on. So I'll go to the three dots, go to the admin. I hope now you guys know that where is autopilot. So it is available into the AI trust layer. And there you have something which is called autopilot for everyone. Okay, I'll go to the tenant. And yes, this is the same tenant which I have been working on. So we have seen all the starting prompts and everything, right? Now, to get started with context grounding, in the same AI trust layer, you would have a tab which is called the context grounding. Okay, click on that tab, and here you would be able to manage all the context, right? So when I go here and try to go to this, I select this tenant because I only have one tenant. You might be working in an organization, you have multiple tenant, select that respective tenant, select the folder. I am working on the shared folder, right? And to create a new one, I have this option where I say, it's asking me to create a new index. But I don't have a index, and I even don't have the storage bucket, right? Data source. So for that, first thing is we need to have a index, and we need to have a storage bucket or integration service connection also we can utilize, right? So which simply means that in case you want to use context grounding in autopilot for everyone, you have to upload the data somewhere. It can be a storage bucket, or it can be an integration service connection. Let's start with the storage bucket. Okay, so where is the storage bucket? Storage bucket is part of orchestrator. Okay, so to do that, I'll click on these 9 dots and we'll go to orchestrator, right? Make sure that you are connected to the same tenant. Okay, why we are going that? Because context grounding in autopilot is asking me for this information which I don't have, right? So I'm going to orchestrator. Step one, make sure that you are connected to the same folder, which is the shared. You might have a different folder for autopilot. Select that, and at the top you have an option which is called storage bucket. Okay, so I already have one storage bucket here which says Mukesh Kala. So let me go here and I create a new storage bucket. I'll go here and I'll say create a new storage bucket, and this one I will call maybe about Mukesh, and this we are creating for autopilot. So I'll just write AP at the end, so which says about Mukesh and autopilot, right? So I would just say that good practice, give this would have information about Mukesh, right? So good practice, always give information, description, so that you are able to understand, right? So I created a storage bucket which is called about Mukesh and for autopilot, and then I'll leave everything to the default setting and I'll go and I'll say create. Okay, so I have this storage bucket which is called about Mukesh AP, and if I click on that, this is now blank, right? So now I have to give it some context, I have to upload some information, right? So what I have got is, in the input files I have my profile and I have included some information in it, right? So I'm simply going to go here and I'll simply say upload new file. I'll browse the file and I'll just upload this my complete resume, right? So that would have some information, and I would say a couple of lot more information today which autopilot does not have. I'm just going and I uploading it to the storage bucket. Okay, and it has uploaded this file. Now I have an option, I can upload multiple files as well, and you can always manipulate the storage bucket, right? So first thing first, what I have done is I have into my tenant, into that folder which is the shared folder, please remember I am working on the shared folder, right? So in the shared folder I went to storage bucket, I created a new storage bucket for autopilot, you can use the existing one as well, and I uploaded the files, right? Here you can upload the lot of files. So let's say you are creating a use case for a banking, so you can upload the banking data here. Let's say you are creating it for a customer support who are having a lot of queries, so you can upload the document and create some of the use cases, right? But I want to know that what Mukesh did in Vegas, so we uploaded the file. Okay, now still this file is only available in the storage bucket. Autopilot, which means our this guy, does not have that information, so we need to pass that, right? So for that we'll go back to the automation cloud, we'll go back to the same tab which is context grounding, select the tenant, the folder, right, shared folder, that's why I told remember the folder, and then I go here and I say add new, and then it is asking me the index, so I will create an index, I'll call it index underscore maybe I'll call it about Mukesh, right? You understood the drill. So whatever we have uploaded, now we are creating an index. I will provide a description, I'll say Mukesh Kala index. Okay, and then I'll simply select the storage bucket. Now in the storage bucket, it is going to give us the same option, select the correct folder, and then the storage bucket, right? So the storage bucket which we have created was this one, about Mukesh Kala autopilot, and now you would see here you have an option that which files you want to include for the context, right? In case you have a use case where you want to have only specific kind of files, you always can select that, but for me I have only one file and I want to keep it to all, and then I simply click on this guy which says sync now, right? So what is happening is I have given the index of the, I have created an index on top of the file which I uploaded to the storage bucket, and now if you see in the context grounding I have an index which is available here. Okay, and this same index now I can actually go and utilize in autopilot for everyone. Okay, so for that I'll simply go back to autopilot for everyone, which is the same folder, we'll go to the respective tenant where we have been working. I hope you all of have this, right? Starting prompt is the same where we have everything, so I'll collapse this. Just after the starting prompt, now you have something which is called the context grounding. In the context grounding you see an option which says enable the index, click on that, and now it's asking me which folder. So the folder here is the shared. What is the index name? So this is the same index which we created. then description for the autopilot, you can give some information, something like this. So I can say that this information is about Mukesh Kala and his activities, maybe. Yeah, and then I just say enable. Okay, and then it has enabled the index on my default tenant for the shared folders, right? So now all you have to do is you have to just go back to the autopilot and you have to refresh the policies, right? Now to refresh the policies, all you have to do is right click on the UiPath assistant and you can simply click on refresh policies, or you can simply restart the UiPath assistant as well. Okay, so once your policy has been restarted, right, let's try to use the same prompts. This time we have enabled the context grounding. Okay, let's try to ask the first question. Who is Mukesh Kala now? Last time it has only that limited context from that, but this time I have the index here, and you can see here autopilot is able to understand that it is coming from that index, and this time it has given me much more precise information about myself, which is like Mukesh is a 4 times MVP, he is a certified architect, he has a 10 plus experience, what all technologies I have, where I have been into the conferences, right, and content creation, YouTube certifications, and all this information it was able to get it from the file which I uploaded to provide the context, right? Now for the important question. What did Mukesh do in Las Vegas, right? So based on the information provided, Mukesh was a speaker into UiPath Forward Las Vegas 2024, right? So I was there in Vegas for UiPath Forward conference as a speaker. What was the topic? And it gives me that information, right? So I hope now, looking at this, you guys understood what is context, right? So basically when I tried to do it for the first time, it was not aware of who is Mukesh, where is Las Vegas and all, but as soon as I provided the context, it was able to get me that, right? So with context, you are actually able to do a lot of more things. You provide the LLMs from hallucination, you are able to get more precise business responses, and you are actually get the accurate responses and not just any vague responses from internet, right? So that is why context grounding is important, and people who are looking for enterprise use cases, this thing is must for you, right? And lastly, again, just to reconvey, in case you are new to context grounding, please refer the video which I shared in the link in the description to better understand context grounding, right? And please do try context grounding on your own. If you were successfully able to get the context grounding, let your network know that you are learning these advanced technology by posting it on LinkedIn. Feel free to tag me. That will let your network potential recruiters know that yes, you are aware of this new agentic and exploring autopilot for everyone, right? So with that, wrapping this video here, I'll appreciate your feedback on this content. Any more questions, any more doubts, feel free to write me in the comments, and see you in the next video of Autopilot for Everyone.